Welcome to 365 Christian Men, where every day we aim to inspire and encourage with real life stories about men. December 5th, Joseph Hovsepian. At age 12, Joseph gave his life to the Lord Jesus. At 17, Joseph volunteered to serve in the Royal Greek Air Force as a wireless engineer, and he served the king's plane. At 20, he traveled 10 days at sea, 2 days by train, and arrived in Montreal, tired, sick, and almost penniless. 2 days later, he met a group of people from Temple Baptist Church, and he was home. For 60 years, he served that church, the last 36 as its volunteer pastor. Joseph has baptized close to 200 people, many of them from non-Christian backgrounds and faiths. Two tracts he wrote have been reproduced millions of times and distributed both locally and around the world, one of them in 12 languages. He has been on the radio every day for over 12 years with a 5-minute inspiration message that airs at noon. His devotional book, God's Workshop, was recently translated into Eastern Armenian and is being distributed freely in Armenia and surrounding areas.
Let the spark that ignites your passion become a flame that burns with purpose. From an early age, a main theme of Joseph's life could be labeled shenanigans. The first time he tinkered with electronics, he was 10 years old. He discovered that touching ends of a nail to the poles on his father's motorcycle battery created a bright glow, and he gleefully continued this experiment until the inevitable happened. The next morning, when his father tried to start the motorcycle, the battery was dead. His father wasn't happy, but Joseph's love for electronics sprung to life. Another time, he mystified his grandfather. Young Joseph invented a mechanism connected to his bedroom ceiling light. When grandfather lay his head on the pillow, the light turned on. And when the old man sat up, the light turned off. Not everyone involved was entirely amused. But the spark inside Joseph never stopped glowing, and eventually it led to a successful career selling and repairing radios and other electronics. Today, his 80-year-old hands, head, and heart are still fixing businesses. He has a shop, and it services antique radios. The theme of his life would shift from shenanigans to restoration. Some of the radios and tape recorders he gets have been neglected for years, in a basement or in a garage. Opening them up often reveals dirt, dead bugs, and even mouse droppings. The wiring and the parts inside may be rusty, dried up, melted, or burned. The exterior may be scratched up and discolored. But Joseph takes great pleasure in the process of restoring each piece brought to him. He says, "While I work on these units, I think of God and His workshop, where He takes battered and neglected lives and deals with every little part of them. He fixes what's broken, cleans and polishes what's tarnished or soiled, and refines the entire person. He removes bad habits and vices that have affected the lost soul. Sometimes the process is quick, but other times it's more painful." 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31 tells us, "Whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God." Understanding the difference that a masterful touch can make to a radio or a person, Joseph approaches people with care and compassion, knowing they can be restored with God's help. Joseph's business is part of his mission field, and he grabs every opportunity to talk with his customers about faith, their eternal souls, and the God who loves them. Next to his business cards on the service counter sit gospel tracts and New Testaments. Joseph said, "I have seen many radios that were discarded become useful and enjoyable again. I've also seen many broken and rejected souls come back to life after the master technician touched them and restored them." Do you have a talent that could meet someone's need? Do you see a way to turn your business into a mission field for sharing the love of Christ? Let the spark that ignites your passion become a flame that burns with purpose.
Thank you for listening to today's story. Every day of the year, our hope is to inspire you with real-life stories of faithful men who have gone before us. Hebrews 12:1 says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." Join us tomorrow for another story at 365christianmen.com.